Let's continue our introduction to OpenMP in small bites. My name is Christian Terboven from RWTH Aachen University. Today's topic is loops with tasks, and this is different from what we learned about so far, where we used threads to execute a loop in parallel. In this session, we will look at the task loop construct, which partitions loops into tasks. So what is a task loop construct? It's a task generating construct. We learned about the pragma-omp task construct so far, and task loop to some extent is similar. So it decomposes a loop into chunks, similar to pragma-omp parallel 4, but instead of executing these chunks by the threads in the team, it creates a task for each loop chunk. And then the OpenMP runtime maps the tasks to the threads available in the team. What is the difference? Well, with pragma-omp parallel 4, meaning the work sharing construct, and the schedule loop schedule that is used by default, the static loop schedule that is used by default, a certain set of chunks is generated, and these chunks are mapped onto the threads available in the team. The task loop partitions the loop into tasks, and the runtime has a significantly higher flexibility when executing these task loops. In addition, the task loop partitioning relaxes some of the requirements of the four work sharing constructs. So for example, the order in which the tasks are executed is different. There are fewer requirements than, for example, the order of chunks that has to be executed by the threads in the team. So decomposing a loop into chunks gives the runtime more flexibility in scheduling these chunks. And in consequence, it might be able to better address load imbalancing or load balancing to avoid load imbalances. This is what I wanted to say. In addition to that, the significant advantage is that tasks can be nested. So the tasks generated by the task loop construct can again generate more tasks. While with a work sharing construct, the for work sharing construct or the do equivalent in Fortran, it's not possible to generate another or to include another work sharing construct. So task parallelism, as I believe I argued before, provides more opportunities to compose or to nest parallelism, to write parallel composable software. So the high level view of the task loop construct is shown here. Yeah? It is followed by a structured for loop, very similar to what we learned about in the for work sharing construct, and it accepts a set of clauses. And these clauses can be sorted into at least five different domains. So there are clauses to manage the data environment. You learned about shared, private, and so forth, and reductions. There are two clauses to influence generation of chunks, which I will explain a few slides later. There are three clauses to implement cutoff strategies. So we learned about the if clause in the context of the computation of Fibonacci numbers. Yeah. So that means if the expression evaluates to false, the task will be executed immediately. There are two clauses that are related to scheduling. This will be the topic of the next video session, task scheduling. And then there are other clauses like collapse, no group, and allocate that are outside of the scope of the introduction into OpenMP that we are discussing here. But before I go into details on how the task is decomposed into, the loop is decomposed into chunks, first I would like to take a look into how it differs from work sharing. On the code example here, actually written in Fortran, you see a comparison of the OMP do, which is a for work sharing construct equivalent in Fortran, and the OMP task loop. And what I would like to emphasize here is that the C code is the same, the OpenMP constructs differ, but the parallel region is the same. Ja, Pragma OP parallel shared x numthreads t. Pragma OP parallel shared x numthreads t. But here we're using a task loop construct, and there we're using a do construct. Why is the result different? If we execute the do loop, the result is 1024. If we execute the task loop, the result is 16384. The difference is that the task loop construct is not the work sharing construct. It might be obvious, but it has a significant consequence. So the do construct implies that this loop is only executed once, and the loop iteration is distributed among the threads of the team. The task loop construct decomposes this loop into tasks, but it's not work sharing. So that means, in the way this code is written, all threads execute this I loop. So the I loop is executed t times. In total, n times t iterations will be executed. And this is a reason, if t is 16, as in this particular example, that the value of x in the two executions differs. So task loop does not distribute iterations to the team of threads. Instead, each thread that encounters a task loop construct will generate tasks that together represent the whole loop. If you want to change that, we have to do something that we already know from task parallel programming. So we need a single executor pattern or something, or you might use different words. But the idea is that we have one thread that encounters a task loop construct with a nested I loop. So that means there's one thread that generates all the tasks. And then the other threads, plus sooner or later, this one thread are available to execute the task. So if we write code like that, the I loop is executed only one. It is decomposed into tasks. All threads participate in the execution of the task. And in consequence, the results are the same. So when to use work sharing and when to use tasks? So you should use tasks if you have a very dynamic or unknown loop load of the individual loop iterations. You should use tasks when you want to compose parallelism on different levels. But you should clearly use the for work sharing construct or the do work sharing construct from Fortran if there's a loop that has a clear memory access pattern, clear meaning to the compiler. So for example, if you do a matrix vector or vector-vector multiplication, then there's no need to go task parallel because the work sharing could give you better performance. What I'm trying to say here is that the task loop construct is a construct to support new use cases like highly imbalanced, irregular loops and so forth. But it's not meant to replace the for work sharing construct or the do work sharing construct. These constructs are still valid, important, and will be around in future versions of OpenMP. Finally, let me add a few details on the grain size and num tasks. So these clauses can influence the way in which the loop is partitioned into tasks. So let's first look at grain size, which is illustrated on the left of this slide. Grain size takes an argument, which is then the size of a grain. And that means the chunks that are generated must have at least number of grain iterations and must have at most two times number of grain iterations. The details in between are implementation defined. But with that, for example, you can make sure that if you would profit with respect to performance from grouping iterations, like here where A, B are probably arrays or vectors. Yeah? If you would profit from grouping multiple iterations together, for example, to exploit caches, you can make sure that an individual chunk is large enough to not lose cache content. The other approach that you could think of to direct the decomposition of a loop into tasks is to specify the number of tasks that shall be generated. And this is where the num task clause comes into play. Again, it takes an argument, which is the number of tasks. And if you specify it, then exactly num task chunks will be generated. But the requirement is that each chunk must have at least one iteration. So if you ask for more tasks to be generated, that there are iterations, then obviously this doesn't work. If both clauses are present, this is not valid. If none of these clauses is present, then the runtime has the flexibility to partition the loop into as many tasks as it thinks are suitable. So the compiler could invest a lot of cleverness or apply a lot of cleverness, for example, to analyze the memory access pattern, but it could also be rather stupid and just implement a scheme in which there's one task per loop iteration. So in OpenMP, we call this implementation defined or quality of the implementation. If you switch compiler versions, the behavior might be different. If you want to have a little bit more control about the behavior, or if you want to, as I explained in the context of the grain size, exploit from grouping iterations together, then you should consider using one of these clauses. I have two additional remarks. So the one I believe I touched upon already, the order of the creation of the task when partitioning, decomposing the loop is not specified. So the compiler could, for example, apply a binary decompositioning scheme. And that could help for some use cases to achieve better performance. And this is what I meant with relaxation of requirements in contrast to the four work sharing construct in C and C++. So tasks are more flexible, but also you have fewer control or less control if it comes to NUMA, if it comes to exploiting caches and so forth. So you have to decide as a programmer which construct is better for your particular needs. And again, do not replace all four or do work sharing constructs by the task loop, unless there's a good reason to do so. And finally, the task loop creates an implicit task group region. So that means at the end of the task loop, there's a, let me call it task barrier. So that means there's a task weight that waits not only for direct childs, but for all tasks that are generated within the extent of the task loop construct. So the code will, or the program execution will only continue here after the task loop, after all tasks have been completed. If you do not want that, you can add the so-called no group clause, which will eliminate the generation of an implicit task group. That means it will eliminate the wait functionality at the end of the task loop for all the tasks that are generated. Again, you as a programmer are required to guarantee that adding a no group, meaning eliminating this waiting functionality, still results in correct code. This was the brief overview of the task loop construct in OpenMP.